We are continuing with our series of how to pass ordinary level biology, and this is part two. Part one, we discussed about the topics that are brought in O-level biology, and part two, we are going to break down the sections of these FRED papers, both practical and theory papers. So if you did not watch the first part, check in the description below. There's a video of the different topics that are set in O-level biology. So before we begin looking at the setting or all the sections of the papers, I want to tell you that this is the current setting of these papers, but if there's any change in the setting, we will notify you just on this channel. So just subscribe to this channel and turn on the notification button. You'll be following us, because if they change these settings, we are going to update you. But as I talk now, at the time of making this video, these are the settings for O-level biology. As I told you, there are two papers, paper one, then paper two or paper three. So you choose between paper two or paper three. So it means in general, we have practicals and theory, and that's what I want to break down. Let's jump on the board. Now we have paper one. Paper one, as I told you, it is a theory paper. It is a theory paper. Now this theory paper is divided into three sections. This theory paper is divided into three sections. The first section is section A. Section A. Now, in section A, they will bring for you 30 objectives. These are objective questions. 30 objective questions adding up to give you 30 marks. In section B, you will have what you call structured questions. Structured questions. Now, these structured questions are going to add up to give you 40 marks. 40 marks. Now, this section has my favorite number when it comes to paper one biology, and I would like to talk about that number. That number is called number 31. Why is it my favorite? Because in the whole paper, you'll find that in the whole section, this number has more marks. And it has a little bit of a common setting, the way they set it. In most cases, they set it and it is a graph. So number 31 is my favorite. Therefore, when you're reading biology, make sure if you want to pass this number 31, every time you find a graph in biology, take it very, very serious, because it has reserved its seat in your paper. So take those graph works very serious. And then finally, when it comes to theory paper one, the last section is section C. Section C. In section C, you have essay questions. Essay type of questions. In these essay types of questions, they will bring four questions. There will be four, but out of the four questions, you will choose two. You choose only two, and the two you will choose will be 15 marks each. 15 marks each. You choose two. The two you will choose will be 15 marks each. Therefore, if you get all of them, that will be 15 times two, that is 30. 30 marks. And when you get 30 marks, when you add all of this, it will be 100 marks. So that is the total. This is the breakdown of paper one theory, biology, all level. And if you want to look at the different topics that are brought in this section, as I told you, the video is in the description below. There are 12 topics that are tested in these different sections. Go in the video below and try to check those topics. So that's the expression of the marks and how the sections are broken down. Let's go to paper two or paper three. Paper two or paper three. This is practical. How do they set practical? How do they bring practical? Now, practical is divided again into three parts. Practical, in every practical, all level, you will get only three types of questions. There will be three questions, and each question will be 20 marks. Now, those 20 marks, each question is brought from a different branch of biology, and there are three branches of biology that they normally test on. So these are the branches of biology that are common in practical. So the first branch of biology is called physiology. Physiology. Please read physiology. I'm just going to give you two examples of what they bring under physiology. The most common things they bring under physiology, you have food tests. We have food tests, and also we have enzymes. But I'm not saying these are the only things they bring under physiology. I'm just giving you an example. Go and read physiology. because it has reserved a seat in practical. That is the question they bring. It has reserved the seat itself, the seat, therefore you have to know it. Another one is plant anatomy. Plant anatomy. Now here in plant anatomy, that's when you do things like leaves, you do things like fruits, you do things like flowers, things like stems and whatsoever, everything that deals with the plants. So plants, flowering plants, that's the first topic in senior one. It has reserved a seat here. Therefore, you have to know it into details. Go and read about it. Then the last section they bring is actually animal anatomy. You need to know animals very well. Animal anatomy. Now, under animal anatomy, some of the things they bring is things like bones. Bones, of course, they bring like fish, they bring like insects and very many others, and very many things they do set under this section. So that was the breakdown of all level biology papers, and I think with this you can go and do your research, read and expound on these different topics so that you can succeed in all level biology. My name is Jibril, representing GVN Academy. Subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss any update in the syllabus or in the settings. Thank you so much.